All right, let's speak to Fred Otunnu, he's the Director of Corporate Affairs, UCC, our regulators. Good evening, Fred.
Yes, good evening, Joel.
How are you today?
Very well, thank you.
Okay, you are our regulators. Let's see how nice I'll try and be to you. UCC has issued deadline after deadline after deadline. There were several deadlines before 29th March. That's the other deadline that you issued. You're going to switch off people. And none of these deadlines has materialized. In fact, you seem to be becoming Uganda Deadline Commission as opposed to Uganda Communications Commission. Are you serious about these deadlines? Anyway.
Thank you, Joel. First of all, I want to say that a number of things have happened since we issued the deadline. And of course, unknown to you, I can tell you without fear of any contradiction that our deadline of 29th of March closed about 2 million subscribers.
Did they close everyone that didn't have their number registered?
About 2 million subscribers have been deactivated from one of the networks. And of course, that was occasioned by the fact that they could not easily verify the subscriber names against those SIM cards issued then. So this deadline is of 20th March, I mean April, is to reinforce further the exercise that is taking place right now. And remember that SIM card registration is not an event. SIM card registration is a process. We, in 2013, when we commenced the registration of SIM cards, did register subscribers based on identification that was varied. Of course, there were multiple. There was all kinds of IDs, ranging from student ID, driver's license, passport, and bottom list was a letter of recommendation from your LCs.
Mm.
Now, that in itself, then, because the law was not very specific on which ID to use, and we had to come up with some kind of identification to be used, and that was in place that people were using at that time. So it was lawful that people provided or submitted that kind of identification.
We're going to talk a little bit more about that particular, the national ID data and so on, but still on the issue of these telecoms, because you say only one has so far switched off about 2 million. I'm wondering, how about the others? It appears to me that these telecoms are too powerful, you can do nothing about this. You know, you come out you issue deadlines and they flout them and you do nothing about it as UCC.
Well, Joel, you know very well that once we issue deadlines and we are very strict about it, they will definitely act.
So these ones, they didn't act because you were not strict about it.
They did act, but there were challenges in implementing the deadline issued then in 2013 because of the authenticity of the documents that were submitted.
How about the one of 29th, the most recent one?
That has been affected.
Are you sure about
that? That has been affected.
And all subscribers that did not register their SIM cards, they are off? Is that what you're telling me?
I can tell you without fear again that one of our own one of our own very staff had her SIM card deactivated because of the process of verification then. But of course, after submission of her documents, it then became clear that her number had to be activated again.
Let's move on now to this particular one, because you're saying those that have not updated their data, everybody needs to go and update their data using their national ID data, the subscribers. But you see, the thing is, not everybody that owns a SIM card or a phone, for that matter, has a national ID. As you must remember, it was only 16 years and above that were registered. Of course, now those have clocked 18 and above. So there's several others that are below that age that have got SIM cards and phones, for that matter, but they don't have national IDs. How are they going to do that?
Well, first of all, for minors that are below 18 years, they cannot contract legally. So therefore, they will have to use, if somebody wants to register their SIM cards, will have to use the identity of an adult. That's provided for in our modus operandi. But I can tell you without fear of contradiction that so far there are about over 6.5 million national IDs that have been issued since the process began.
And how many SIM cards are out there?
SIM cards out there, about 22 million. But remember, of the 22 million SIM cards out there, an individual possesses probably two or three SIM cards. So if you work out the mathematics, the number of the IDs issued may tally with the number of persons that hold SIM cards. So we don't think that is going to be a problem. And the reason why we have issued a fresh deadline is because the process of verification, the process of validation that had been a challenge can now be cured with an authentic document that can be verified against. And this is the process that we have begun, and this is the process that we are very confident that will cure the process of SIM card registration.
Let me try and be a prophet, Fred. 7 days later, you will call a press conference and you're going to issue another deadline. I am almost 100% sure you're not going to fulfill this. You're not going to cut off this one that you're saying go and you update. People will not update and you're going to do nothing about it.
Joel, let
why? Because there's been a precedent, Fred.
Well, Joel, if you want to procrastinate, please do not register. Do not.
Mine are very well registered. I've got two SIM cards, so I'm not one of those going to fall prey to that. Okay. But I'm just really concerned, genuinely concerned, Fred, that
I see
when we keep threatening people and we don't take action, they actually take it for granted. I've met many people who will say, well, UCC, they will just talk about it. You know, they'll do nothing. And people have not registered their SIM cards.
I'll tell you that with the national ID in place, from which we can verify the many sources of documentation that we used earlier, that should now not be a problem. And again, because of the challenge that the operators had, because you cannot just switch off somebody, really, when they have lawfully abided by presenting a document, identification document, at that time of registration. Now we are saying, let us verify, let us validate what we provided for at that time against a national ID. And going forward, the process of verification and validation does not seem to be a very insurmountable task. NIRA, the body that issues national IDs, has assured us that that process is easy to do. So what is going to happen is telcos are going to issue out reminders to subscribers, you and myself and everybody else, to go and present their national IDs to any of their designated...
That's for those that didn't use national IDs at the time.
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
Now, because after the our deadline of or after our directive of 29th, national IDs is now the only document for nationals that is used for registration of SIM cards.
One final question. We need to wrap this up. Are there been concerned about sharing this data that I give you my data that's within the national ID system that now you're going to give it to telecom companies? It's private information and it's plenty of information and they can use it anyhow. There's been concern about that. How are we making sure
this
information is used for the specific purpose for which it is being gotten?
There's first of all levels of access to that information. What the telcos will be able to access is very minimum just for the purpose of SIM card registration. NIRA will not provide the entire data about somebody when it comes to registration of SIM cards. They'll provide what can be verified against the national identification number that is on your national ID. So once that is done, that you are the authentic or you're the person holding that SIM card and holding that that number, then a tick will be given to you. Not about your parents, not about whatever that has been collected about you. So the fear that this data is going to be misused is far from reality. The fact is that the telecom companies are law-abiding entities, and they know the consequences, the penalties are clear if they disclose data to parties or third parties that are not allowed to obtain such information.
All right.
There's an entire process of obtaining such subscriber data, and we are going to be strict on that. And anybody who feels aggrieved that their data has been misused, they have recourse to the law.
Fred Otunnu from UCC, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pleasure.